So the next step here is to add a scoring system. So at the moment, if we get the random number and the elapsed time the same, so if we press enter at the correct time, we just get this message. But what we could do is add some scores in. So we could say you scored 180 if they get it exactly right. If they get it close but not quite right, we could do something like this. So random equals elapsed minus 1, or random equals elapsed plus 1. And what this will do is if they're 1 second out the time, we can give them slightly less scores. So we could say you scored 90. So what's happening here is it's comparing the random number. So say the random number is 3. Now say we pressed it after 2 seconds. So that would be elapsed minus 1, which would be 2 seconds. So if that happens, if we're 1 second out, we can give them a score of 90. And then we could grade it a bit further. Okay, so I'm just going to be lazy here and copy the line, paste it in. But this time, we're going to say 2 seconds. So if they're 2 seconds out, then we can give them slightly less points. So print, you scored 50. Okay, and so on. You could keep going with 3, 4, and so, and carry on, and so on seconds. So we'll just change this to be slightly more offensive. Okay, and then we're good to go. So let's test it out. So this will give us one dart, and we'll see what we do. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Press enter. Ooh, 1 second out. So that's worked there. Okay, so we'll just test it again with one of the other options. The other conditions even. 4, 3, 2, 1. Oops, wrong button. Okay, cool. So that works there. So that's how we can get the scores graded depending on how close we are to the original time.